Ripple bag holders are cheering this morning. That's right. The SEC loses its appeal in the case versus Ripple. But what does that really mean in the big picture? Welcome back, everyone. The XRP bag holders are very pleased this morning, but in my eyes, it's a giant nothing burger. Let's dive into it. Judge dismisses the SEC's attempt to appeal the Ripple ruling. District Judge Annalisa Torres said in a brief ruling on Tuesday that the SEC had failed to meet its burden under the law to show that there were controlling questions of law or that there are substantial grounds for differences of opinion. The decision isn't a complete loss for the SEC, though. The judge set an April 2024 trial date for other issues that still need resolution. The agency could still try to appeal the entire case following that trial. So while people are cheering, what's happening is that they're not paying attention to the gray area, which is where everyone and everything exists. Okay. So like this is far from over. I know the bag holders want to cheer, but this is far from over. So for the people that seem to think that this is over and that's it, you know, I saw some tweets yesterday. Oh, XRP isn't a security. That doesn't make it not a shitcoin. Okay? That's not what happens here. Like, it's not like all of a sudden, oh, XRP is not a security. Yay. No, but it's still a total shitcoin, right? Like, a Chuck E. Cheese token is not a security. But guess what? It is a token issued by a corporation, redeemable through that corporation. It's not a security, okay? It's not a commodity. It's nothing. It's vaporware. Okay? Oh, God, these guys. Anyways, but still, nonetheless, right? We're going to take a look at some important dates that are going to be coming up because, like I said, this is far from over. The Ripple SEC lawsuit can now move forward as the SEC earlier requested that the court stay any remedies litigation and any pretrial proceedings while its interlocutory certification request and any appeal are pending. In this light, Judge Torres put forward the key dates. The Ripple SEC case trial is set to begin. Okay, set to begin April 23rd, 2024 at 9 a.m. next year. Okay, so all of this cheering right now, like, oh my God, yeah, we won, XRP the standard. Not even fucking close. Okay, like, you guys got a long way to go. Okay, long way to go. On December 4th, the parties should submit any motions in limine and all required pretrial filings and deliver to the court the documentary exhibit sought. Oppositions to any motions in limine should be submitted by December 18th, 2023. On April 16th, 2024 at 2 p.m., counsel for all parties should appear for a final pretrial conference, as stated. Before the final pretrial conference, counsel for both parties, along with the parties themselves, should meet in person for at least 1 hour to discuss the settlement of the matter. So there's a long way to go still. Okay, that's number one. Number two, something I find absolutely hilarious, and I'm sure is just a coincidence, right? So the judge dismissed the case, dismissed the appeal, okay, on October, what was it, October 3rd, right? And this is pretty funny here because this article came out actually on September 30th. On the first day of every month, Ripple unlocks a billion XRP tokens. So isn't that peculiar and interesting and not a coincidence, right? That it's just a reminder, right? It's just a reminder, hey, listen, you know, XRP is going to unlock about a billion tokens right at the beginning of the month. And look at that positive news, positive looking news that just came out at the right time. Look at that. For a little 5% bump so XRP can dump their bags and keep the lights on, right? Because every corporation needs revenue. See, this is why we tell you that there's a difference between Bitcoin and shitcoin. There is no corporation for Bitcoin. This truly is the money of enemies. This really is censorship-resistant ledger that no single entity can control or coerce. But when you're buying shitcoins, and you're trying to sell people on the shitcoin dream, you're lying to them. It's all corporate backed crap. You may as well be shilling them Chuck E. Cheese tokens. And the reality is, they can probably get more out of those Chuck E. Cheese tokens because they can go to the fucking restaurant and cash it in for some shitty prize. Okay? Anyways, guys. So look, XRP, I saw some comments from Bitcoiners stating that that means that because the SEC lost the appeal, that in altcoiners' eyes, it puts XRP on the same footing as Bitcoin. Look, it may seem that way from a legal standpoint, but the reality is that at the end of the day, this shitcoin does not have any of the qualities that Bitcoin does. So it's completely irrelevant what the law, what the law states about what that token is. And for the people that think that they're fighting the state with this corporate issued token, don't forget, Ripple Labs submitted a CBDC framework paper, okay, to the Fed. So if you think for a second that they aren't scared shitless of somehow this whole thing falling apart, they want to make sure, XRP wants to make sure that they're as close to the money spigot as possible, because that is their only fighting chance. But in reality, it makes no difference because it's still just a corporate token and it doesn't have any of the qualities of Bitcoin. And finally, even if XRP isn't a security, that doesn't make it anything worthwhile. Never forget, there's a whole bunch of businesses that issue fake money that is redeemable for their products. None of those things are classified as securities. That doesn't make them any more valuable. It's not a saving grace. So anyways, guys, hate to be the bearer of bad news. I know that the shitcoiners are definitely going to pump the hopium. I saw some bullshit tweet from some XRP guy yesterday talking about the utility bull run. I've been here for 6 years, okay? The utility bull run, that's the shit they sold us on back in 2017, okay? Everyone's still waiting for the utility bull run. There's a whole bunch of wrecked bag holders that are holding zombie tokens with zero liquidity, zero use case, no one actually doing anything with them, and they're all waiting for the utility bull run. It's not coming, guys. It's not coming. Bitcoin is the use case. Bitcoin is the network. It's the only one. Anyways, if you like this episode, consider liking and subscribing. Help us grow the channel, and I will catch you guys all tomorrow.